two churches back to back. Wow, they're like identical almost. The Victorian. Oh, look at Victorian. Oh, it's beautiful. And look at that church. What is it? Addison United Methodist. They're all Frederick Augustine Welcoming Center History House. Oh, wow. That one's really old. That's early 1800s. Yeah, there too. Boy, they just fixed that one up recently, it looks like. Nice old hotel. Oh, wow. Yes, it is a hotel. Erected 1914. This is cool. Keystone Garage. Hartzell House. Bed and breakfast. Isn't that cute? Oh my goodness. Oh, it's gorgeous. Oh, so nice. Oh, look at that Victorian fish scale siding and all. Over the lamppost. The tavern there? No, maybe it's here. Black, that's the blacksmith. Yeah. Oh, and what is this up here? Oh, wow. Petersburg Addison Toll House. Frank C. Wright and Sons Builders? Like, that's not Franklin Lloyd Wright, is it? In honor of those of Somerset County who served their nation in the cause of world liberty in the Great War and in memory of those who made the supreme sacrifice. Crossing Chapter, the American. Erected by the Great Daughters of Revolutions, 1924. That's awesome. Wow. That's so cool. Rates of toll on the Cumberland Road in Pennsylvania. Every score of sheep is 6 cents. Same with the hogs. Cattle's 12 cents. Horse and rider, 4 cents. Every led or drove horse mule or ass, 3 cents. Every cart or wagon whose wheels do not exceed 3 inches in breadth drawn by one horse or pair of oxen, 4 cents. All carts or wagons whose wheels exceed 8 inches in breadth, free. Any person refusing or neglecting to pay a toll is a fine of $3. National Register of Historic Places. How cool is that? Daughters of the American Revolution. I'm gonna cry. So cool. Wow. Great crossing. About 1/2 mile above this point is the Great Crossings of the Yucatán River, where George Washington crossed November 18, 1753, was sent as envoy by Governor Dinwiddie of Virginia to the French commandment at Fort Lebeau. Washington, on his military expedition to the Ohio, encamped there with his forces May 18th to the 24th. And from that point, explored the Youghiogheny. There, also Major General Braddock with his army crossed June 24, 1755 on his march against Fort Duquesne. This tablet is placed by the Great Crossing Chapter. Yeah, it is so cool. Honor of Addison, military, who made the supreme sacrifice, 1943. Like a husky. Yeah, you're doing a good job. The old Petersburg Toll House is the only hand-cut native stone toll house in Pennsylvania. It is an authentic reflection of the structure as it existed in 1835, when toll collection began. The interior, with its original flooring and period furnishings, convey a sense of what domestic life was like for the toll collector and his family, whose annual salary was about $200 plus free living quarters. I've never seen a toll house. I'd like to go inside. Let's see if we can peek in there. See an old lamp, that's it. You know, the toll to drive across Pennsylvania is more than that toll collector made in a year. Have restrooms. How cool. Oh, those must be picnics, a little park. Oh, you can drive up in here. And there's, it looks like another memorial over there. Wow. Toll House, one of the six original toll houses on the Cumberland or National Road, is on the hill opposite. Built after the road was turned over to the state in 1835 by the U.S. Restored and preserved by the DAR, Daughters of American Revolution. So Highway 40 is the National Road. I'm just learning this. And that's the road that they'd come through on, the Cumberland Road. Okay, I'm learning. Okay, let's go back through Addison. Let's see, there it is, Historic National Road. Gotta learn a lot more about that. You know, I've never heard of the Historic National Road. I just kind of, you know. Now I want to know more. The older I get, the more I want to know. And the more I realize I don't know. There's the toll house. Parking, I didn't even see that sign. Toll house parking. Addison Park. Awesome toll house. Awesome. So you can't really see anything, but I'll leave it on as we go through. I want to come back through. Borough building. Boy, that's an old one. Stone garage. Yeah. Rush Hotel. Gorgeous. It's beautiful. Check out the churches. John's Lutheran Church. Christ is risen, alleluia. This big old house, looks like it's under construction. It's lovely. Quick drive through Addison Cemetery. Historic figures in here. There's an obelisk over there to the right and a cannon. Oh, there it is. See the obelisk? Obelisk. I'm not sure. I'm not a very good pronunciator. Oh, it's Hartzell. General Hartzell died November 10th, 1888, age 59 years. Hiram Hartzell. Well, maybe it's two of them. I can't read the first name. It's Hartzell. sell hotel or house over there. Alright, one more drive through. Oh, I didn't even see. How did I not see this? The old schoolhouse. And there's the bell. Those white things are coming along. Oh, the toll. And then there's. Can I park over here? Oh, look at that Victorian in the sunlight. Can't make it out. So sad, such significant history, and not even anything to explain what it is. The Humbertson School? What is that? How'd you like that in your backyard? Is that an old barn? That's gotta be like an old school. That door must have been added. That garage door. Because it has, isn't that, I think that's a cupola. It may have been an old church. Church, school, town hall building. Humbertson School, dedicated memory. Caroline and Barbara Rush. That's the Rush Hotel, 2001.
Let's peek.
Oh, it's furnished and everything. There's the old stove. Have a piano. And school desks and teacher's desk.
That's so nice.
Even have the outhouse. What do I like this?
A bird. Oh, the door opens.
Yeah, it's original. Step right up and get your splinter. Maybe a better view. And all the youngins sit in the front. See how they're smaller, the desk? First through eighth grade. And the next year you move to the next seat. Then the next year the next seat until you got all the way to the back.
I'm so curious on what that building is. It's gorgeous.
Addison, Pennsylvania, Heritage Road. The Hartzell House. So that's who we saw with the obelisk in the cemetery. Is that the post office? No way.
In on the other side of Route 40, above that service station. There you go. You are totally welcome to take pictures and do whatever, to hang out in here.
Cool.
It's got like a really cool vibe, and I just, the lady that sold it to me also owned that house.
That Victorian?
Victorian style house.
Oh, wow.
So when she was selling it, she turned down several offers because she said the people that wanted to buy it were just going to tear it down for boat parking. She said, I'll sell it to you if you don't tear it down. I'm like, well, I can't afford to tear it down. So we do martial arts up here, and then there's like a full gym downstairs.
Oh, that's so cool. That is so cool. Now, what are these, the restrooms? I know they're
these
now.
These two up here are restrooms.
Were they original?
I honestly don't know. I mean, of course, you know, the fixtures are newer and stuff, but this used to be tied, I think, from front to back.
I was going to say, because it had the two doors, so it had, wow, yeah.
And that little step out on the back there was added on.
I have to step real quick. I have to run too. I thought it was a post office at first, and I was like, because I saw the business thing, and I thought, surely that's not a post office.
No, I don't think there's an old post office up here.
Yeah. Oh, it's gorgeous. Thank you.
There's so much that I want to do. Of course, it needs painted, and there's a lot of stuff that needs done. But
oh, it's so cute.
I just don't make the money enough to do everything right away.
Oh, well, they're really expensive to do these houses. And schools.
Are you sure if you want to look at it, you're welcome to. I'm not trying to twist your arm.
Yeah, so sure.
Okay,
I'm going to go right up the street. Oh, yeah. So I just met Carrie, and she owns the schoolhouse there, and she gave me a little tour. That was nice. And now we're going to go look at her old B&B. She's making a bed and breakfast house. It's over 100 years old. So we're going to check that out over by the cemetery. Oh, how cute.
Built the foundation and everything, so we're thinking of making it into like a wedding venue and putting a roof on. Yeah, it's pretty neat.
I like your little weather vane there. I like the roof is like, I just love it. I love that old look. And it's huge.
It is huge. Now, of course, all this was added on and they put siding over the old wood siding.
Uh-huh.
But our plan is to like put all the old gingerbread back in the eaves and everything.
Uh-huh.
And
oh wow,
this was added on.
Yeah, but it's nice.
We kind of redid a bunch of things for the Airbnb.
Oh my gosh,
the kitchen's definitely not the era, but we did the best we could.
Oh, but it's nice. It's so nice. I love the floor. And the bar stools, I just love it. Oh, and this is nice. Why do you have the double doors?
The pantry, yeah.
Yeah.
But it has all of the old shelves and stuff.
Oh, my goodness.
With the plaster and lath walls and everything.
Oh, wow, yeah.
But this in here is definitely the crown jewel of the house.
Oh my goodness. Look at that.
All of those, the original glass in the buildings.
Do those doors slide?
No. Well, no, they don't slide. Yeah, the pocket doors do.
Pocket doors, yeah.
There's pocket doors
Here.
There
on that side, yeah. Oh, wow. Oh, it's gorgeous. Oh, it's gorgeous.
We put in the coffered ceilings because everything else was just like the...
Oh, that's copper?
Yeah, well, it's a drop ceiling.
Uh-huh.
And it has, you know, those panels sit in on rails, but it needed something to boost the room for kind of like the vibe we were going for.
Yeah.
And we did it in these two rooms. And this, because the ceilings were just like this hallway.
Gorgeous. That's your bookcase.
Yeah, this is all original.
Oh, that's beautiful. Now, did you have to? You didn't do anything at all to this?
No.
Wow, the wood
just
is so.
Murphy's oil soap.
Yeah.
And it's been like that. Like it was never painted. So this house, I'm gonna say, is about 100 years old. I'm not real clear on the history of it, but it was built by a man named Manliff Dean, and I'm not sure if he was or his father was a Civil War veteran.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow.
And his father, I know, was buried in the cemetery above. And Manliff was, I think he went to university or college to be an attorney, but he never practiced law. Uh-huh. He ended up being a banker. And I think he was in Summerfield before they flooded Summerfield for the Yawk Lake.
Oh.
I don't know if you knew that or not.
No, I don't know.
Did you cross the bridge on 40 down there?
Yes.
Okay, so under that bridge was an entire town named Summerfield.
Wow.
And there's just tons of history about that town, and there's some old pictures you can find. And I know when my grandmother was little, she said she remembers when they flooded all of that.
Wow.
To make the lake. And so Manliff, like I said, he was a banker, and I'm not sure if he was a banker in Summerfield, but there were several houses here that were owned by professionals, and so we named the house Banker's Row for Manliff.
Uh-huh.
And there's just tons of so much history here that's super cool. So
it is so cool that. Thank you so much for letting me come in and see this.
Welcome.
I mean, let's get one more look at this. Oh, you did such a great job. The ceilings are just, they're fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Spectacular. And I love the curtains. It's really nice.
There's one room in here that is definitely oddball because it was just an odd room when we ended up with the house. So we just made it into a video game room.
Oh.
Because it is just
awesome.
But the bedroom straight across the hallway is my favorite bedroom in the house.
Oh, wow. Your bathroom's really nice.
Thank you.
I like your sink, too. And your toilet?
The sink is original. You can tell by the porcelain's worn and the rust ring in the drain.
That's so nice.
I have to figure out how to repair that.
But. You've done so well. It's beautiful. Oh, wow. Oh, I love it. And I love the ceiling, too.
The ceiling was here when Mom and Dad bought the house. So.
That bed looks very comfy.
And all the huge old closets.
You could live in there.
Yeah.
That's huge. Wow, it's really nice.
Thank you.
And I like how you have your suitcase and your little trunk.
There's the suitcase came from a local lady. She said it was her father's.
Uh-huh.
When he was a truck driver and he traveled, and that was the suitcase he took with him all the time. And this calendar is from a local family.
H.G. Bender, yeah. Oh, that's great. I love it.
You can take a look upstairs if you want.
Okay, sure. Sure. Oh, it's so nice. And I love the windows. You get the beveled.
Yeah, those are all original.
Yeah. You can always tell in those old glass. It's got a little wave to it.
A few weeks ago, we had guests here, and there was a group of 10 or 12 people. And when they left, I found out that they were a traveling bartending entertainment troupe. So I was a little bit nervous having them in my parents' house. But it turned out fine.
Wow, it's huge up here.
Yeah, it is huge.
Wow. So you just rent it out, like you have it on Airbnb now?
It's on Airbnb, VRBO, booking.com. Yep.
Nice.
We were just here cleaning today. I'll probably finish up in the morning.
It's gorgeous. I like the birds.
Tons of old newspapers. This is Somerset newspaper. This one's from 06.
Oh, wow. Now, where did you get those?
A couple people I know that are into antiques. These came from my friend Sean Suter. He's a big antiques person, and just had them stashed away. And these rooms, I think, were actually closets. Like this room.
Oh,
we
turned
into a bunk room with the comic.
Oh, that's so cute.
Yeah.
Oh, what a great idea.
And then that room straight, there's a room in that closet straight across.
Oh, in the closet?
You can open it.
A room?
If you open that
door. Oh, wow.
You can open that door.
This door?
Uh-huh. So we're...
Oh, wow.
It's like a speakeasy type room. So we're still kind of working on this.
And this goes...
That's actually an attic up there. It's not finished, but if we... worked on it hard enough, we could probably make that a third floor.
Oh, that's so great. Oh, I love that too.
Thank you.
This is great taste.
And these are real bullet holes. Don't ask me how they got there.
Oh, wow. Maybe those traveling bartenders.
No, I don't think it was them.
Oh, wow. That's like a Duncan Fife style. Yeah, that's nice. Oh, the Rat Pack.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great. Oh, I love this picture. I've always liked that.
My dad's actually a retired iron worker, and that was his picture.
Really?
He said that's one of his favorite iron worker pictures.
Oh, wow. That's great. Yeah. So. I love it. The closets are really big.
I'm not exactly sure. I guess they were closets, but they're... large enough to be.
Yeah, they have to be, right? Yeah. Oh, yeah, that wardrobe is beautiful. The whole house.
This bedroom actually has the best view. If you look out over the fields and.
Oh, wow. That is so gorgeous.
You can see all the way to Seven Springs from here. I don't know if you know, that's a ski resort way over there.
Oh, no. I'm pretty new to the area, just till like yesterday.
Oh, so are you just traveling?
I might get a little bit more of the outside of it,
sure.
But then after that, I'm going to head on down. I'm going to Grantsville real quick.
Okay.
Yeah, but I love this, Carrie. It's so nice, and I appreciate you for letting me come in.
You're welcome. Thank you so
much. Roosevelt's dead. He is. The Banker's Row, Addison, Pennsylvania. It's a B&B, and it's beautiful. What a great experience. And now we're going to go get one more look at the two-room schoolhouse, and then we're going to head over to Grantsville. What a beautiful town. be a little schoolhouse. I don't know, it's something. It's little. I thought they made the schoolhouse into a post office. I was like, how cool would that be? It's so cool.
There it is. And there's that chimney I love. Windows. Addison, Pennsylvania. I don't want to go, but I'm going to have to. I'm running out of daylight. I've got to get to Grantsville. Memories from yesteryear. June 30th, 2024. All right, I have to go now. Bye, schoolhouse.